Hello and welcome to Sovereign RPG. I am Sovereign, and you have just walked into the channel of short and sweet gaming guides. I am new on the scene, but I hope this does not discourage you from liking and subbing if you do find these useful. Bannerlord is a pretty big game, even in its current early access state, but one of the cores of the game is army management. Going from zero to hero is most people's dreams whilst playing Mount & Blade. In this guide, we'll talk about the best troops in all factions, and the special units for each of them. Remember that if you want to check out the trees for yourself, you just need to right click on a unit portrait, or press N and go into the troops tab. So let's get started. Britannia, although they have the Falxmen, which in themselves are very good two-handed units, their special units are by far my favourite in the game. These guys are like the elves of Bannerlord. Britannia has the only horseless special unit, the Britannian Highborn Newfline, by far my favourite line by a country mile. The mixture of two-hand and bow is insanely overpowered right now. The range damage is ridiculous. I can use 100 Britannian Fian champions to wipe out armies of 500 with zero, yes zero, casualties. Granted, getting 100 of them will take you a long time, but this is something definitely worth working towards. They are great in open field, closed in, siege defense, siege attack, just put them on the map anywhere and you're looking at a lot of green. Landia, mostly anti-cavalry units filled with pikemen and heavy shielded crossbowmen. The Vlandian armies are a jack of all trades for the most part, and are a very good pick if you want one faction army. Unlike the Britannian special unit, the Bannerlight leaves much to be desired. With one hand and pole arm not being as effective as you may think, there are two better options for special units. Sturgia, boasting some of the best anti-infantry units in the shock troops and the two-handed Ulfedna. Great for siege defense, but having a Sturgian-only armor leaves much to be desired. Though it can be done. The special unit is another generic heavy cavalry unit in the Sturgian Warrior Sunline. This time, one-handed and bow being the specialties of this unit. Slightly better than the Vlandian version, but not by much. Asari have both great cavalry in the Mamelukes, being ranged cavalry, and the Master Archer itself. Definitely one of the better armies to field against infantry in an open field. The special heavy cavalry unit, the Asari being the Asari Youth Line, boasting high stats in pole arm and throwing, definitely putting them in the higher end of the spectrum. Very useful open field, where they can freely throw and get to charge speed. Khazates, my second favourite faction in the Mount & Blade franchise. Granted, the AI was pretty bad in Warband, but in this game, by god, these guys favour fast, rapid attacks on enemies. Blasting in, doing massive damage and flying out. Circling, like vultures. The Heavy Lancers and Darken are both favourites of the Khazate army users. But for me, just the standard heavy horse archers are so easy to get to and are very, very strong in the open fields. These guys do suffer in siege attack and defense lines in higher difficulties. Their special unit is the Khazate Noble Sunline. They boast bow and polearm, and being very good at it. Easily for me, the second strongest of the special units in the game. The reason why they are not first is the fact that the Britannian line are so destructive on literally every single battlefield, while the Khazate troops suffer in close quarters. And finally, we have the Empire. These guys have by far the best one-faction army, with the Legionary being the best defensible infantry unit in the game. Great frontline fighter and really overpowered in siege defenses. Very hard to break the line. They also have the Palatine Guard and the Sergeant Crossbowman hitting for massive damage at ridiculous range. Very slow on the reload though. Their special units are the Imperial Vigler Recruit Line. These guys are the best melee horsemen in the game, hands down. Their one weakness is the lack of ranged, putting them third for me, but super strong nonetheless. If you are into melee heavy cavalry, then these are the ones to go for. And that's all we have for this guide, and my personal opinion on the best units in Bannerlord. Let me know down below what your favourite troops are and your army composition. I would love to hear. If you made it this far, I just want to say thank you for sticking with me this long, and if you did, then make sure to like and sub to the channel for future short and sweet gaming guides in Mount & Blade 2 Bannerlord, and many other RPGs in the future. Bye safe.